It's time for a video about video. Haven't done one of those in a while. Now all the things you see on the table here in front of the two computers in the background are recent thrift store finds. Now this Tascam Porta Studio I got for $10, and these typically sell for between $50 and $100 on eBay in working condition, so that was definitely a good deal. I don't think I'll be doing a dedicated video about this because the 8-bit guy already did a very comprehensive video about this particular model, the MFP01, on his 8-bit keys channel, so I'll include a link to that video in the description if you want to watch that. And I tested it and it is in working condition. This may probably get its own video in the future sometime. It's an old Microsoft mouse from around 1989 in the original box, and this is the bus mouse version, so it includes a card to plug into an expansion slot, so it does not use a PS2 or a serial port. It's actually a bus mouse, which was a more rare version of these. It includes an old DOS version of Microsoft Paintbrush that was before it became popular in Windows as what most people know today as MS Paint. That was its ancestor, a DOS version of that program. So that will probably get its own video once I get a old age-appropriate computer set up to install that in and test it out. Now here is probably the star of the show. It's one of these combo DVD VHS units, but this one's a little more special because it's not just a DVD player, it's also a DVD recorder, and it does HD 1080p upscaling through an HDMI output, as it says right there, HDMI. It has hi-fi stereo VHS and also a DV input, so you can record from a DV camcorder such as the one I'm using right now, which was also a thrift store find. I'll get into that a little later. So this is a really nice unit. It can do recording from DVD to VHS or from VHS to DVD. Now I assume it won't let you copy Macrovision encoded DVDs or tapes, but I'll have to see if that is true, because it does advertise one-touch dubbing either way. And if I believe the manual right, it can record simultaneously to both DVD and VHS if you use timer recording. Also has a USB input for plugging a flash drive with photos and MP3 files on it, and it can automatically generate a slideshow with music and then record that to DVD. So this is a very nice combo unit. Did not test it fully in the store because I didn't have a TV there to hook it up to, but I did put in a tape and it did seem to play and fast forward and rewind fine. And this is the price I paid, very low, only $4. These things usually go for at least $15 to $20, even the less fancy ones that are only a DVD player and not a DVD recorder. And this one is a model RDR-VX535, and there's the date code 9C, which means it's from 2009, which would make this my newest VHS unit. Here you can see the HDMI output, some kind of set-top box control, because this is new enough that it does not have a built-in TV tuner, because by 2009, if this would have included a TV tuner, it would have to be digital TV compliant, and most manufacturers didn't do that. They just opted to remove the tuner from their VHS and DVD units rather than paying the extra money to include a digital tuner. It does have inputs and outputs here. Unfortunately, there's no S-video output. It's only an input, but you do get component video output as well as the HDMI and standard composite. It also has digital audio. I don't have anything to hook that up to right now, but I'm really wondering if that will work when playing VHS or if it only works when you're playing DVDs. I did find a remote that I think would work with it. I don't know if this is the exact model or not, but it was the closest I could find on the shelf, so hopefully it would work. It does include DVD and video, so I think this is the one for it. I think I paid $3 for this. Now here's the next thrift store find. It's a Sony Mini DV Handycam. It's a DCR TRV27. I won't do a full video about this because UXW Bill found the same model at another thrift store, and he did a pretty thorough video about it, talking about all the controls and features and giving a demonstration of it. But I have not tested this, so I'll have to see if it works. There is a tape inside, and it came with this shoulder strap and a lens cap. A little bit dirty, but not too bad. That is the price I paid, a little bit on the high side for something that was untested, but these things are getting more valuable these days on eBay, especially these models that can transfer video from analog sources, such as this one. Because if we look here, this thing has a plethora of inputs and outputs. S-video and standard composite input and output, DV, USB, LANC, microphone, and headphone jacks. Now the USB is not for doing video anymore. They did support USB streaming, but it was low quality resolution, and Sony only supported it up through Windows XP, so anything newer than that, it won't work. So for transferring video, you'll have to use FireWire, or what it calls iLink. So I won't do a full video about this, but I'll just connect it to power and see if it works. This model is from, where's the date code on it? 2C, that means 2002. So this camcorder is about 15 years old. And I was looking all over the store for a matching power supply and battery for it, because usually when you find a camcorder, it often has those accessories somewhere else in the store. But that day I couldn't find anything for this camcorder, but I did find this. It's a much older Sony camcorder power supply for one of the L-series batteries. And I also found this battery on the shelf there. And it's old enough that it doesn't say InfoLithium L, because back when this was new, there was no other type of InfoLithium battery yet, so they didn't have to distinguish it. So this is probably from the late 90s. And I did try charging it, and it does hold at least somewhat of a charge. And it has this slider thing on it I haven't seen before on InfoLithium batteries. I don't know what the purpose of this is, except maybe when you charge it all the way, you can slide it out and it shows green to indicate that it's a fully charged battery. I don't know. This charger has one of those battery dongles on it because it doesn't plug right into the camcorder. So I couldn't use it with this camcorder because it's the wrong type. But I could use this with the camcorder I'm using right now to record. But in the meantime, I'll pop on one of my existing InfoLithium M batteries. And this one is already fully charged. There is a tape in here. Don't know what's recorded on it. So let me pop out the screen. This is a nice big screen on it. I believe it's 3.5 inches, but it's not a touch screen. You can see all the touch controls are on the camcorder itself. And these things normally get quite worn out under heavy use, but only one that has a little bit of wear on it is the volume up button. So let's try to power this on in playback mode so you can see what's on that tape. Uh-oh. Doesn't like that. It's telling me to eject the tape. Now, even if this tape mechanism isn't working, I could still use this to convert video from an analog source through those inputs on the side and output it to a computer through FireWire. So it's not a lost cause. It says the Jazz Monkeys. Sounds like some kind of amateur jazz group. Let's see if I can at least close it without a tape in there. Alright, let's try camera mode, see if that works. Telling me to set the clock, which is normal. Okay, I think that's, oh, that's memory mode. I want camera mode. Clock set. Well, that's a fast zoom. I don't see anything through the lens. There is no lens cap on there, so I don't know if the iris is stuck or what. Okay, here we go, another mini DV tape. Well, let's see what happens with this one. Hasn't complained yet. Let's try rewinding. Unless it's already rewound all the way. Play. Some glitching, but it is playing. Maybe I'll try cleaning the heads. Oh, it's better already. No more glitching.
Wait. Con G. B.
This is from some car dealer, Nissan dealer. They used it to do videos about their used cars they were selling. All the videos are in Spanish, advertising their used cars they had for sale back in 2004, such as this Chevy pickup.
Tenemos esta 99 Chevy Silverado. Está en perfectísimas condiciones. Tiene una pintura en excelentísimas condiciones.
So, it does have some promise. Can be used for playing mini DV tapes and for transferring analog to digital. But it looks like the iris is stuck or something like that. So, I have to try whacking this thing around, see if I can get that to work correctly in camera recording mode. Otherwise, it's a pretty nice camcorder. So rather than use the mini DV camcorder to record this part of the video as I had originally planned, I've switched over to another digital handycam. It's a DCR TRV250. I believe I already did a video about it, so I don't need to do it again. And this is the camcorder I recorded the first part of this video on. The digital weight, as you can see there, DCR TRV315. This is from 1999.
Oh no, I'm in the 90s.
This one has some colorful things inside the microphone grill for some reason. Doesn't seem to affect its operation though. This one was one of the better ones. Includes Nightshot, of course. This one does support playing analog tapes and converting them to digital through the FireWire output, which makes it handy for playing Hi8 and Video 8 tapes into your computer. Also has microphone and headphone jacks, as well as S-Video and composite input and output. And there's a hot shoe on the top there for connecting a light or an external microphone. So, pretty nice camcorder. Well, this is the battery that I got at the thrift store, the old InfoLithium that doesn't even say InfoLithium L on it because it's too old. Let's see if it still holds a charge from when I charged it a couple days ago. Okay. There we go. Sony InfoLithium system. How much battery time is it going to show? It takes a few seconds for that to come up on the display. Nothing so far. But the battery is working. There we go. 149 minutes. Don't know how accurate that is, but seems to be taking a pretty good charge. Did have to put a new coin cell battery in there. There's all your controls and your viewfinder. Don't believe this is a color viewfinder. Let's see. It actually is a color viewfinder. All right. They didn't advertise it unlike the mini DV camcorder. So that's nice to have. It also has this little status indicator display on the outside of the LCD panel. So you can see your recording time and how much battery life you have remaining, and it will start flashing the tape indicator when you're running out of tape or if you don't have a tape in there. So that's the DCR TRV315 Digital 8 Handycam. That little 9A is the date code, meaning 1999. And I forgot to mention, this camcorder came with a tape in it, as well as the mini DV one. No label on it, but it's some unknown amateur rock band playing outside at night in the middle of the summer using a car's headlights to light them up. So at the end of this video, I'll include a little bit of this unknown rock band, as well as the Jazz Monkeys, so you can get some amateur music included in this video on both Digital 8 and Mini DV. Since the overwhelming winner of my last viewer poll was cats, in just a moment we're going to have one on camera here. So step outside. There we go. Very excited to see me, as usual. Yes, you're going to be on YouTube, kitty. This is our outside cat. Very friendly. Yep. You should be looking at it the other way. You're upside down right now. Now to test this DVD-VCR combo unit, I have it connected to a small flat panel TV, and I have a selection of tapes and DVDs to use. I have a Macrovision encoded VHS tape, a tape that is not encoded with any kind of copy protection, even though it says video lock copy protected. That's fake, there is no such thing. I have a blank VHS tape, a Macrovision encoded DVD, a promotional DVD from Mercedes-Benz that I'm pretty sure is not Macrovision encoded, and a blank DVD-R disc. I only have 5 minutes left on this tape that I'm recording this video on, so I'm going to try to make this quick. This unit does power on. First I'll try the VCR, it's already set to video. I'll try this one first since I don't really care if it gets eaten. I already have uploaded this to YouTube anyway. So, let's see. Like I said, I tested the VCR in the store and I'm pretty sure it works. Play. There we go. Let's see if we have any sound. This is not a very good quality recording on this tape, so I'm not going to be too disappointed if it's a little shaky and fuzzy.
We listen to our customers, and many of our customers have told us that sometimes they need to know the older version as well as the newer version of popular software programs.
Alright, that seems to be working. So let's just quickly test the DVD. Eject. Let's try this Mercedes DVD. Hit play. Loading, please wait. And it's playing. Alright. I'm gonna unwrap this blank tape and see if I can do a dub from DVD to VHS. The VHS tape is unwrapped. Brand new T120 Mexel standard grade tape. Alright, I think I got it recording from DVD to VHS. For some reason, this is the correct remote, but it's not working, even though it is putting out infrared. For some reason, this thing is not recognizing it, so I don't know if this is somehow broken or if the infrared sensor on that is not working, but I had to fiddle around with the buttons for quite a while, but I eventually got it recording, at least I think, from DVD to VHS. For some reason, they just showed a Sony TV on that video, even though this is a Mercedes-Benz video. But let me stop and see if it worked. Well, that would have worked, except the VCR input is set to line 1, and I can't find any way to change that from the unit itself. So it recorded a minute and a half of blank video because it was trying to record from the line input instead of from the DVD. And I put in my Back to the Future 3 tape, and it can play it just fine, but when I switch over to DVD and hit record, it says you cannot record copy protected movie. So that answers our question. It cannot record Macrovision encoded tapes to DVD. I'm now using its DV input connected to one of my other mini DV handycams. I'm playing that Jazz Monkeys tape. If this is supposed to be some kind of jazz band, I don't know what is going on here, because it's just some very shaky home video footage. I don't know, maybe the jazz thing comes later on the tape, but either way, I'm currently dubbing this to DVD using this. I don't know if you can see that icon on the display there, indicating that it's recording, and it's a plus R disc. So at least that feature is working. I can use this to dub DV tapes, either mini DV or digital 8, or if I use one of those analog compatible handycams, I can even play a analog tape in this and put in this and record it directly to DVD. I've just reached the end of the tape on this camera, so I switched over to my flip camera to record this little ending. So I basically ended up with one fully functional Digital 8 Handycam, which I used to record the first part of this video. One semi-functional mini DV Handycam, which can play tapes and transfer analog to digital video just fine, but the image sensor or the lens assembly or something is not working right on that. One battery charger and battery that work fine. One tape of some unknown rock band. One DVD VCR combo unit with limited functionality. At least, I don't know, either this remote is not working or the sensor on that is not working, but whatever I can do from the front panel seems to be working fine, including that so-called Jazz Monkeys tape. Since I'm already wasting a DVD-R disc, I might as well let it play all the way through, even though this is probably not anything worth watching. So that's my thrift store video products find video for 2017. And like I said, I'll eventually make a video about this coming up sometime in the future.
Okay. Let's do it.
Now, unfortunately, our time on the W Chica show is almost up, so we're just going to do a quick goodbye, and then tune in next time for another episode of the W Chicas. Adios! Bye! This is the W Chicas signing off. I'm Olivia.
I'm Emily.
I'm Whitmer.
I'm Williamson.
And this was the W Chicas show. Now, we've already brought the fun to you. So now, it's time for us to say goodbye. Bye!
Watch me!
We're gonna kill you, Whitmer. You're not allowed to play this.